And welcome back to, oh god,
Batman!
Welcome back to another episode of the Non-Cooperators. Can I just call us the Cooperators? Can I? You're here. That's the point of it. If we're playing a co-op game, they'll know. It's the game! Can we just call it the Cooperator? Fuck you!
It's a Non-Cooperator episode. But you can say Cooperators, it's fine. I'm here because I'm here to support him. When I do a Non-Cooperator episode, he's never there for me.
Skype call me.
Skype call? I do Skype call you. You're still sleeping. He's a fucking vampire, by the way. He sleeps during the day.
I woke up at 1. A.M.
Yeah. And I have a life, so I have to stay up during the day. I'm up mostly 24-7, and I do all the editing and everything. He does nothing. Nothing at all.
I play with you.
That's how it...
You know what that's like?
You know what, I'll
it's
admit...
It's great!
I was gonna say, you know what, I'll admit, it is stressful, but it's great!
How am I doing today, Gary Busey? You're doing great! Good! I keep it up!
Love you.
I don't know, I'm wearing this fucking Blue Clues shirt, as you said.
Ghetto Blues Clues.
Ghetto Blues Clues. The black man hosting it, it's like not even like the nice black guy. Like,
you know who has to be? It has, I don't know. His
Terry
name.
Crew!
Yes, that's him.
Oh my god, Terry Crew in Blue's Clues. Be like, who the fuck is all where you at?
Wait, what Terry Crew would he be? Would he be the one from White Chicks? Like with that personality? Because I like that one where he's dancing with the whistle in the club.
Oh, you know, you just like a Terry Crew ecstasy.
Yeah, I like when he's dancing in the club like that.
No,
with the whistle.
I like angry Terry Crew. Like, remember, and you ever seen Soul Play?
No, sadly.
Damn it.
He's in it. I'll have to watch it.
Well, he's in it for a short time, but he plays a bouncer. But,
Really?
God, I can't remember the actor's name, the white guy.
I remember it was like...
Tom Arnold.
I
think it's his name. He goes up to him, he's like, excuse me. He turns around, motherfucker, you just touched me! But he's just so hilarious, Terry Crew.
I think I saw a movie, I think it was called Friday After Next or something, where he was in it, where a pimp hurt his balls with, like, pliers or something.
Yes,
shit.
Yes. That's also another good... That's the first movie I saw him in.
He was like, oh!
It was, Cat Williams and Terry Crew. That's who it was.
That guy.
But, who, Cat Williams?
No, that guy.
But, I'm trying to remember how that scene went. Because, he was also hilarious in it. He was, he played a guy who just came out of prison. Guy who just got out of prison, and he's like, you know, he's gay.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, I don't know, he just banged a whole bunch of dudes in prison, or whatever that is. But
why did I think of the movie Boat Trip for some reason when you mentioned that? Oh, that's right. They were pretending to be gay guys. That's right.
Yeah, I was gonna be like, what the hell? Are you confusing Terry Crew with Cuban Gooding?
No. I don't get black people confused.
Wow!
I just get black blind for performers confused.
I was gonna be like, I don't get black people confused. Oh, you're the first person to not think that you're racist enough to say, like, oh, they all look alike.
It's like, oh wow, Will Smith, do you know every other black person?
Oh, we're so racist that we try not
to be. That's a typical racist mentality. It's like, oh, this person is this race. They must magically know everything else. It's like a hive mind collection.
Is that the same thing with Asian people and everything?
I think so. Like, any racist thing, it's like that, basically.
Anyway, we're moving out of racism back to more racism of Terry Crew and, it's Friday After Next, where, mm-hmm. The first scene that you see him in, he's like, he's in, like, these jumper boxers, and he's just, like, working out, he's got, like, just showing off his pecs and everything. He's like, Craig and Daddy! Boom! Just the two! I can't say it because it's a lot of, you know, the N-word.
What? If only you know how to edit.
I mean, I know I do know how to edit. It's just like, it's a,
no,
pain,
no, no.
It's a pain in the ass.
You don't know how to edit, like, audio?
I know.
Portion tell?
I did it before. Remember in Star Wars when I had to do the old Dave Chappelle skit where he's doing the Samuel Jackson?
I have to watch that. You'll have to
show my god!
No, you'll have to show me which one. Because, like,
when I did the Samuel...
You could just do that and, like, just put sounds over it. It could be...
I bleeped it out, basically. But it takes a while. Because I can't bleep it out of Windows Movie Maker because it
We still use Windows Movie Maker.
It fades it out. It's the easiest thing that works for me.
How do we... Wait, what did you use to bleep it out? A sound or just get rid of it?
A sound.
What sound?
The bleep noise. A beep!
I mean, that's funny. But I think it should be something a little more comical.
No, like what the Game Grumps do, because whenever they say...
They use the elephants. I'm thinking...
They use the elephants. Well, when Barry was doing the animations and everything, he would have the elephants just like, he was like, as he said, oh, this motherfucker, and the elephants start trying by, and then all of a sudden you just hear Danny laughing while Aaron's still talking. Because, like, oh, obviously he said something really hilarious. It took me a while to figure it out. What the hell are you saying? Oh, he's saying the N-word while Barry is animating elephants stampeding by while editing the elephant noise, which, that's a lot of work, honestly.
I can give you more work. I can do that.
You died.
Good. I did. Because that's what happens when I try to give you work.
Stop.
That's what happens when I try to give you work. No. I was going to say, why not, if you were to edit it, why not make the spring noise from Sonic and then put a spring over our mouths as an image, give you more work with visual and audio?
I don't know how to do visual on Windows Movie Maker. I don't even think Windows Movie Maker even can do visual.
Guys, aside from Adobe, can you please tell us some good movie editing software?
You're probably just saying Adobe.
Aside from Adobe and Sony Vegas.
Something that's actually easy to maneuver, because like
they're good. They're good. We just need something else in a budget.
I'll tell you what. From someone who's going from Windows Movie Maker, knows how to do editing software in there, basic stuff, how can he easily move to something else that is just as easy? Because I'm doing all the work. Joe does nothing.
I would love to do more, but I suck.
Learn, like how I did.
He didn't learn.
He lost
the sparklers.
Oh my god, he did. Well, that was the one thing he lost. Well, the sparklers was the one good thing on this thing. Now he's got nothing.
He's taking it up a notch.
Well, like I said, you said this is a remake of 1 and 2, right?
Essentially. Watch this. Check this out.
Oh, he did step it up.
Yeah. When he's nearing the final stages, he steps things up. Just for a moment.
That is kind of cool. So this is basically just, we're just playing a remake of Sonic 1 and 2. And
yeah, basically.
So why do we even bother playing 1 and 2 in the first place?
Because they're better than this.
Yeah. Well, it's not really better, it's just different.
Oh, man.
This is basically Sonic. This is basically what Sonic looks like in Sonic Adventure.
I don't get why you have Windows Movie Maker on Windows 10, but I don't.
Gotta download it or keep it. You deleted yours. You said, Yes, you did. You deleted it. You were saying, I don't need this shit because this is taking up space. Delete. And you know I'm right because that's usually your MO. Oh, it's taking up space. Delete.
You know, I'm strongly urged to say you're wrong, but simply because I don't remember.
Wow, we do have a lot of room.
Yeah, we have a lot of room.
Jesus.
Yeah.
We don't need that much room, but okay. Well, I mean, you could just take this part and just, like, drag it down a little bit. Just
that limits us even more.
Yeah, we don't need this. We don't need... Raise your hands!
I will censor you like Fox censors news.
So anyway, you don't even know how to censor. But as I was...
Beep.
As I was saying... I can't say the N-word. Well, I can, but I have to bleep it out. It just takes a lot of work. So, what I was talking about with Terry Crew, back to that fucking thing.
Oh, yeah, we were talking about him.
He was, like, saying, Craig and Danny, just the two I need to see. As he's working out, it's like, yo, what's up, OG, Triple OG, as he's saying, and I just going, the titty dance.
How can he do that? That seems like a lot of work.
You flex your muscles. Like, I used to be able to do that when I actually had some pecs, and I just got tits.
I had some in high school because we had a gym, and it was fun. But that was it.
It wasn't an actual gym. It was basically like, here's the back
room,
and there's the...
I was benching 200 in high school.
Yeah, there was...
I was 200.
Was it the isolation bench, or was it the actual...
It was the one where you lean back.
Yeah, that's the isolation bench. I was doing that as well. Like, you're doing the other bench where you have the bar and you have a spotter. No, again, that 200...
200? No, not on that.
Yeah, that one I can only do, like, maybe, I don't know, 150? I don't remember. But I was doing, make 200 on the isolation one.
Mm-hmm. Go on.
Oh, from back in Friday After Next. So, yeah, there really isn't that much to talk about. Like, he basically came out of prison, and he's gay because he banged a whole bunch of dudes in prison. And basically, he's threatening them, like saying, "Oh, I'm gonna get really familiar with yous."
Oh shit! And Anna Jones, they got shit on this.
You know what's ironic enough? You know what's ironic? Harrison Ford does not like his Indiana Jones, nor does he like his.
Who's Harrison Ford?
The guy who plays Indiana Jones.
Who's he?
Exactly. Keep losing your wings because you're not cooperating with me when it comes to...
You know what?
Really?
Next time on the Cooperators.